In case you haven't already heard, the last Boeing 747 will soon roll off Boeing's production line. Once the finishing touches are applied, the final Boeing 747-8F will be delivered to Atlas Air. This upcoming delivery will mark the end of an iconic half-century-long era in the aviation industry. Let's examine what we know so far about this final delivery. So far, we know that Atlas Air is expecting three more 747-8Fs from Boeing. Of course, with so much work being put into each jumbo jet, massive teams of workers are working on these three concurrently, with work on the last 747 ever to be built now underway. The three jets, according to plane spotters, will be registered November 861 Golf Tango, November 862 Golf Tango, and November 863 Golf Tango. Respectively, their manufacturer serial numbers will be 67148, 67149, and 67150. At this point in time, we know that November 861 Golf Tango took its first flight on August 19th and was ferried to Portland for painting. We can assume the two subsequent jets aren't yet ready for these stages just yet. If we go purely by these numbers and assume that Boeing will complete each jet in the order that work was started, then it can be presumed that the last ever 747 will have MSN 67150 with registration November 863 Golf Tango. For months now, we've known about this eventuality, with this final jet expected to roll off the assembly line this October, which is only 1 to 2 months away. Oh, how time flies! For several decades, from its launch until 2019, the 747 remained superiorly popular, even as the Airbus A380 came into the picture to spice up the competition between the jumbo jets. Boeing kept the queen going strong by stretching out the length and introducing new variants, allowing airlines to use the aircraft for commercial and cargo services until nearly every significant international carrier had the Boeing 747 in its fleet. While the end of the queen was foreseen for a more distant future, the introductions of new generation twin-engined revolutionaries and the collapse in demand for travel during the pandemic made the end come sooner than Boeing and aviation enthusiasts would have preferred. Paired with rising fuel costs, the Boeing 747 was no longer as economical as it once was, and only a small handful of airlines still operate passenger flights using the Queen. Still, the 747 proves more useful in these times for its cargo capabilities. Atlas Air and UPS currently stand on the podium as the biggest Boeing 747 operators, with both the -400F and the -8F variants in their respective fleets. As the Queen reaches the end of her time, Boeing has essentially hit the brakes on one of its most significant offerings. With the production of the Boeing 747s winding down, the manufacturer has relied more heavily upon its other notable and more popular modern wide bodies, the Boeing 777 and 787 Dreamliner. How do you feel about the end being near for 747 production? And when exactly do you think the last 747 will stop flying? Could it be 40 years from now, or perhaps even longer? Let us know what you think by leaving a comment. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.